Various gaseous compounds, such as methane and nitrous oxide gas, can be formed or accumulated in wastewater treatment processes in a liquid phase, and they may need to be measured and quantified for different purposes. The main objective of the salting out method is to determine the concentration of gases dissolved in wastewater by stripping them out through the oversaturation of the liquid phase with salts for their analytical determination. The salting out method relies on the principle that the solubility of gases like methane and nitrous oxide is highly dependent on the salt concentration in the liquid. The higher the salt concentration, the higher the concentration of salts that dissolve in the liquid phase, and the lower the concentration of gases that can dissolve or remain dissolved. If the liquid phase is oversaturated with salts, the solubility of the dissolved gases gets close to zero and they are stripped out from the water phase. This will lead to a build-up of pressure in the headspace of a closed recipient or container. The pressure build-up can be correlated with the volume of the gases stripped out. Once they are stripped out and present in the headspace of a recipient or container, gas samples can be collected for the determination of the concentration of gases by gas chromatography. The procedure of the salting out method comprises the following steps. In the first step, add 20 grams of sodium chloride to a serum bottle. Then, in situ, pour into the serum bottle a defined volume of fresh wastewater. Immediately after pouring the wastewater into the serum bottle, close it airtight with a cap and mix vigorously. By connecting a graduated syringe with a needle to the serum bottle and submerging the syringe in water, the gas stripped out will cause a pressure build-up. The difference in volumes before, V0, and after, V1, the pressure release, can be correlated to the volume of the gases that have been stripped out from the water phase due to the oversaturation with salt. Once the pressure has been released and equilibrated, the concentration of gases can be estimated by, for example, gas chromatography, by collecting a sample from the gas phase. The volume of the headspace can be estimated by uncapping the serum bottle and measuring its weight before, weight 1, and after, weight 2, filling the serum bottle with water, up to the volume occupied by the rubber stopper and the metallic cap. Finally, the gas concentration in the water phase can be estimated by dividing the mass of off gases calculated and the volume of the wastewater sample collected. This is an example of the working sheet suggested to conduct the salting out method. The salting out method for the determination of dissolved gas concentrations is performed in 120 milliliter serum bottles. First, weigh and pour into the serum bottle 20 grams of sodium chloride. Also, gather all the required materials for the collection of wastewater samples in the field. A funnel can be used to pour the salt into the serum bottle. Prepare the required number of serum bottles depending on the number of samples to collect, and bearing in mind that the analyses should be carried out in triplicate. Once the salt has been poured in, put the rubber stopper and the lid on the bottles without closing them, and leave them ready with the rest of the materials for the in-situ collection of samples. After the proper preparations, samples are collected at the wastewater treatment plant. Using a syringe with a catheter tip and a 10-centimetre silicon tube, 50 millilitres of sample is added carefully to the serum bottle filled with salt. To avoid the stripping of the gases, the silicon tube should be held under the rising liquid surface when pouring the wastewater sample into the bottle, in order to keep the liquid-gas interface as small as possible. Immediately after adding the syringe content to the bottle is closed airtight by crimping it with the rubber stopper and the aluminium cap. The sealed bottle is shaken vigorously to dissolve the salt. As a consequence of the high salt concentration, the microbial activity in the sludge samples is halted, and the dissolved gases escape from the liquid phase to the headspace and build up pressure. Thereafter, transport the samples to the laboratory to continue with the experiment. Before sampling the headspace of the serum bottles to conduct the gas analysis with gas chromatography, the pressure in the headspace needs to be equilibrated with the atmospheric pressure by allowing the gas in the headspace to expand in a submerged graduated syringe and measuring the volume expansion. Thus, a graduated syringe or burette is submerged in a beaker with water, connected with the tip to a tube with a needle. The initial headspace volume in the syringe is registered as volume zero. Then the rubber stopper of the serum bottle is pierced with a needle, and subsequently the headspace volume of the syringe will expand. Now the water level in the syringe can be brought back to the water level in the beaker to cancel out the pressure of the water column, and the new headspace volume in the syringe, volume 1, can be registered. After the gas pressure in the headspace has been brought to atmospheric pressure and the volume expansion measured, the headspace is sampled with the gas syringe and the methane and or nitrous oxide concentrations are determined by gas chromatography. Finally, the volume of the headspace of the serum bottle needs to be determined. For this purpose, the water level of the salt-saturated sample and the lowest level occupied by the rubber stopper are marked. The weight of the bottle is registered as weight zero. Subsequently, the bottle is filled with water up to the mark of the stopper, and the weight of the bottle, weight 1, is also registered. First, fill out the working spreadsheet with the collected data. In particular, the volumes to quantify the gases stripped out and weights to estimate the headspace volume should be filled in. In this example, only the generation of methane was assessed. The volume of the gas stripped out, Vs, is computed with the first expression, as the difference between the initial and final volumes in the syringe. The volume of the headspace, VHS, is estimated as the difference between the weights before and after filling the serum bottle up to the top. Thus, the total concentration of methane gas stripped out can be estimated with the expression of ideal gases, considering the corresponding pressure P, temperature T, and the constant of gases R. The total concentration of methane gas present in the wastewater phase can be computed as the concentration estimated with the expression of ideal gases, N, divided by the volume of the wastewater sample, V sample. Using the values estimated for this example and presented in the table, the estimated concentration of methane present in the wastewater ranges between 0.19 and 0.22 milligrams per litre.